Hey there, how are you going? Another live stream here from our Linux side. I decided to probably split this in maybe two or three live streams. So let's first a little bit introduction to terminal multiplexers. You see we are pretty busy cross-compiling stuff, and you see I got myself much more usable or much more used to this terminal multiplexing stuff, and this is TMUX. We had this in the live stream. I historically, the last 20 years, used Screen from the GNU project. But there is a modern TMUX that I discovered already for quite some years and only recently started to get used to. So what is this terminal multiplexing stuff? And after this short 5-minute introduction as documentation for everyone else here, of course, experts among you already know this. And people were like crying there in the comments the last time how not amazing this screen experience was, and people even recommended the iLife package BioU something. And so this is TMUX, as you see. And why I migrated, first of all, historically, also what this is, so this allows you to multiplex multiple terminal sessions in one terminal, like either a graphical one like an Xterm or whatever, or the Linux virtual console stuff. And what this mostly allows, you might ask, yeah, why do I need this fancy stuff here on the terminal? This is mostly on servers, right? Of course, locally you can open here a couple of tabs, or Windows for that matter, but also, yeah, of course you want terminal on F1, right, for more help. For example, read the freaking manual. But usually what this allows, and what probably many people who say, what is this nonsense even about, this is mostly, at least for me anyway, leaving the stuff running on the server so you can attach and detach. And so you run this once, like TMUX or Screen, and later you can detach and resume, like AT or a attach or something, but AT works for Screen. This is Screen R, and obviously those programs are not compatible. So if you use Screen, then you need to use Screen and reattach, or you use TMUX and you reattach. And that allows you to leave this running on a server or a Raspberry Pi or whatever, and also splits this here, right? So this fancy goodness I have personally not even used for 20 years. Now you might call that is lazy. What kind of Unix Jedi are you even when you didn't even use this? Yeah, didn't really. As you see, you can open tabs and windows and yeah, just a couple of them, right? But this is indeed super cool. And one thing, so this is TMUX is much more modern, and maybe Dietard and others will call out, yeah, in BioU, something of Ubuntu. This is more amazing, but this TMUX, I like the code base. Looked on the first glance much cleaner than the historic old Screen. So what this allows you, of course, you can navigate between those, and as you see here, the focus. And what is pretty cool, I'm sure many of those features Screen can do, but maybe not, I don't know, the splitting of those windows and panes is slightly different in Screen. And I now only got to use them in TMUX, so yeah, whatever. Probably I will stay with TMUX for now anyway, as I like stupid small keep it simple software, so maybe this Bayan Yal Bufa thing there is better, but whatever, this works for me and I can now have an overview. Previously I always switched between those, so you can have multiple, right? Control Alt C to create a new one, and then you can switch between them, and maybe leave me in the comments if you want this larger. So this is like Control A, or in, so Screen is Control A and TMUX is by default Control B, but I remapped this because I'm more used to Control A, and this is, as you may or may not see, slightly closer here on the keyboard. So I remapped this works. So detach is then either Control AD for Screen or Control BD for TMUX. Again, I remapped this, so from now on I will just say Control A because whatever. So Control AD for detach. And my config right now is this, just to rebind this, unbind this prefix to CA and unbind CB, Control B, and then just a little bit of, well, certainly some much larger history, but also just tiny little bit of more like control A escape scrolling in the history, for example. And so what is also not foreground but attach, and what is pretty cool, so again, the total nerds like myself there in the audience will say, yeah, this is boring, skip to the next live stream. But what is pretty cool now also, again, not sure what the other do, but so of course you can have multiple of those panes here. So you can have one setup of these and then another setup with control A, 2, 3 and back and forth. And also zoom, right? So control A set for zoom allows you to toggle here, which by the way, I can also zoom this to that camera here for maybe some better illustration. I've chosen this angle so that you have a little bit of visibility of how this works here on the keyboard, right? And so control A set for zoom. For example, you have here all your, well, not everyone builds like massive distribution stuff like myself, but this allows you, for example, in my case, have here some overview, some builds like PowerPC 32, Power, which also failed, yeah, fun fact. Yeah, device mapper, I already know why. PowerPC 64 and Spark 64, which also failed. And then you see this failed, you control A set for zoom in there, and then take a look what the heck is going on with proc PS, because this build, so fun fact, which also only is a shared file. So yeah, a couple of this directory shared file stuff should not really happen. I need to investigate another day, another night. Yeah, this still keeps failing. We probably can work around this. This is not how you should be doing this. Another night, maybe tomorrow or some other weekend, I will debug why this sometimes happens. If something happens like this, make files touch the directory somehow, which again, they should not do. Can also manually. So normally I don't do this. Historically, I usually spend then a couple of more hours, but you see the scalability of everything gets a little bit out of hand. And yeah, pretty convenient. And in retrospect, you see now this past here. In retrospect, I have to say, darn it, I should have used this for a decade already. Totally amazing stuff. And of course, the key bindings partially totally crazy. So you need some sheet for that, whatever is next best here. So mostly, of course, some of the stuff is obvious. C for create, N and P for next and previous. I usually use Control A, Control A to swap between next and previous, because the pane splits here are totally annoying with Control A percent and quotes. So splitting would be, do I even want to do that now? Or maybe not. I use, but yeah, whatever. Also, fun fact, Q shows the pane number. So you get here some nice Control A, Q for, yeah, 0, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, nice stuff. And especially the zoom in and out stuff for me here, this is golden. Probably looks like maybe better than in a Hollywood movie. This, by the way, is a not too defect ARM build, which maybe, not even sure, maybe only the Linux kernel failed. So overall, this looks quite good, but IP root, nah. This might actually be, and you see how amazing this is, a couple of builds. You zoom in there and let's see, this might be just something I fixed already. Yeah, this is that, so that is probably just rebuilding 0 either. Was it Bison, I think? Let's also, wait a second, did I maybe, which build was it even? This was PowerPC 64. Yeah, of course it is. This is also, you see, with all the added revenue here of $3 a day on YouTube, I can finally fix a decade old small annoyances like this config helper stuff being built for the cross compiler already and then doesn't load. So I need to, again, totally small stuff, just that over the decades I never really was motivated, and apparently nobody else was enough to send a patch in for that. Yeah, I just wanted to give a short overview. So that's it for this live stream. We will continue with some more amazing cross-build stuff. I hope you enjoyed this brief overview. Many people commented The live streams are too long, and if you're here for long live streams, then stay tuned for another fun one. Maybe I can give you an overview what everything failed today, and we still have here quite some stuff you see. Oh, by the way, one last thing probably. In Tmux, it is much nicer. I hope this is somewhat visible here on this screen capture, but I wanted to have this a little bit with the key bindings. Moving those, resizing and moving those panes in screen was totally annoying. In Tmux, it's at least by default much nicer, so that is just Control A and the arrow keys, which are just barely on the screen. So Control A and, oh wait a second, Control A and hold. So like this. So Control A, hold, and then you can resize this. In at least the default with screen, this was relatively complicated with escape, colon, resize, or whatever. I'm sure you can bind this to some keys, but this, also move. So this looks much more modern, at least in the default configuration. So Control A, arrow keys to navigate in the panes, Control A and hold to resize, and and even resizing the whole pane setup like this. Easy peasy, totally a no-brainer. Maybe I probably, because this was only the first test today, I probably may like it. Also, as usual, after a day, I got a little bit used to that. Not too much learning curve, but I might prefer, but again, in the morning when I started with this, I thought like, yeah, the large thing for editing, I might prefer for left to right text on the left. But after a day, because I didn't really want to change it then, because this was building here most of the day in as secondary office laptop thing. But now I'm used to this, but probably maybe tomorrow I try to have the big window for the main editing here and the small windows for the lock scrolling there. Let's see, where are we? IP route 2, did we rebuild? Not sure, let's rebuild the 0. Or maybe are we rebuild that there, then let's continue the build there. So this is T2, of course, on our amazing source rolling release stuff, just cross-compiling, because totally amazing cross-compile stuff, so cross-compiled all the architectures today. The Graver is back, welcome there. Let's detach here the chat window, and because then I can slightly zoom it better for... the Graver, thanks for testing that this EFI stuff boots in VirtualBox, that is nice. Maybe that means I should also have VirtualBox handy for this testing. Devi Jones asks, what's your dev setup? Have you only just started using Tmux? I've previously used Screen for 20 years already, but again, I always only used the full Windows, right? So like this, a new window here, and then multiple. So I also Screen, as seen on my previous live stream, Screen has this same concept of panes. I only used them a couple of days ago for the YouTube overview, but I have to say it was like 2 days ago when I realized, damn, this pane stuff is totally amazing, especially with the zoom in stuff. And Screen 20 years, but only this single window stuff like this, which allows me basically like tabs on the data center, right? So long time Screen user, but I switched to Tmux because the reason I actually switched to Tmux is that sometimes the Screen windows got stuck. So you were like heavily editing here something, and I'm not sure why this happened of Secure Shell, but I don't think it's like Secure Shell. It's probably more like fast typing back and forth, and then somehow the escape key handling, at least is my feeling. So my impression as developer is that for me, with like heavy load, Screen sometimes had this escape code handling a little bit stuck. So that is actually the main reason why I started to switch to Tmux just last month, because also Screen wasn't updated for 10 years previously. It is now being updated again But of course, T-Max looks a little bit modern and maybe more active, and maybe non-GNU is also a good thing, but Python. So that was Spark 64 and all. Okay, good. Otherwise, I just use my other desk setup. Would be if I, where do I have? Also, this is also start to mix the key bindings after. What was my screen binding even for another workspace? Anyway, otherwise, locally, I also do not use such kind of setup. Locally, I also use just a couple of RxVT Unicodes and mostly XEmacs, and for more fancy stuff, for small tech stuff, I use VI, and for larger. So yeah, so much to the flame war. Even as one person, you can use VI and Emacs. Although I use the same decade, not really much maintained XEmacs flavor there. So why is this? Did I not build? Okay, whatever. But yeah, so let's see other comments. Thanks for the reminder to support me on Patreon. That is really cool. And again, why do I make these videos? Of course, I've done here this T2 open source stuff for, I've run this wrong because live on YouTube, that is why it was rebuilding this. It was not using Bison correctly, so this is among all the small details. But probably we stop the live stream here and start a new one in going over what all went wrong. With the cross builds, we have previously the last days built the regular builds x86, AMD64, as well as special flavors of Musel. And now I've built the regular versions of regular GCC, glibc, old fashioned classic T2 open source distribution built from scratch. I only wanted to share how much more amazing this can be if you are a little bit of a power user, and let's see. Probably the Graver great anxious for the NXT alternative for, is there a TMux alternative for Windows? I would guess this TMux works in the Windows subsystem for Linux, and the Graver right. MKFS VFAT, we added this. I would hope, I'm not sure, but maybe did I? Anyway, let's do this in the next live stream. The Graver plugins for TMux to show CPU load and such. Yeah, so the only thing in TMux, so I personally, maybe CPU load you could have in this status line there. Personally, let's double check if it's on the, or it is on the screen capture. Not the most, it wastes a line. I don't really need this, but maybe the only useful thing here would be the CPU, because I neither need the, and yeah, you can switch this off, right? So, by the way, fun fact, because we are on a totally in-depth channel, which again, thanks for watching, sharing, liking, and subscribing and stuff, and Patreon. One shout out, I initially got totally crazy with a detach. So initially, because the screen bindings, I also wonder a little bit, I always wonder a little bit why have they not used the same screen bindings when they re-implemented TMux like in screen. But yeah, maybe they thought the screen bindings in screen suck and they better do them completely different. Because this means the learning curve is larger, because if you are coming from screen or switch, then all the key bindings are different. And when I started to change them here in .tmux.conf, which by the way, whatever was, anyway, doesn't matter. You can switch the status off with whatever the keyword was for that. But if you edit this file, it does not have effect, right? So I probably wasted 20 minutes the other months editing the config file and probably reattaching, because somehow I naively assumed that just editing this and reattaching would allow me to use the edited screen bindings. And then only after reading the freaking manual, I figured that you need to start a new server because this, when we detach, the server process is still running, the daemon, and this is why the screen, the key bindings do not update in the running daemon. So if you modify the screen bindings, you cannot detach and reattach. You need to have a fully new session like this and can't do that with your existing session. So that's probably the biggest that can easily save you 20 minutes if you start getting into there and editing the screen, the key bindings. Plugins, yeah, so the only, for me, this is a little bit waste of screen real estate here, this blue status line, especially with my server name and the date, whatever, don't really need that. The only thing is I would want to have those line back, but CPU load is actually not too bad, but that I would like have the screen here, if that is possible, to have just one, one tiny rectangle there, that would be perfect for me, or I don't really need this anyway if I have a top running here anyway, but yeah. Thoughts on Ritual Storm, so if we continue to going over those comments, then it will take forever. Let's see what else we have here. Did I not see Dietart here? No, maybe I miss. Red Dead ESP, Richard Stolen, maybe in the other something or other live stream. Two errors, wrong magic number, and you need to load the kernel first. Is this after installation? Try to boot the install. I get, yeah, so maybe that is a known bug that we discussed slightly in the live stream. You need to edit the Linux entry, because from PowerPC it is, the grub config is generated with VM Linux with a X. You need to change this to the Z for the compressed version for x86. It's just this X versus Z. I already fixed this and the next builds will already do this correctly. Should be able to boot into the installer, but the installation itself can't install grub right now. So next we really need to also make this EFI stuff more perfect. Danny, again, just X versus Z for the, if something like this happens, then they usually, it's not like reinstalling or partitions and just like read the source or Google other errors or just certainly ask here. Because installer cannot create FAT32 partition right now. That's it for this live stream. We had quite some people tuning in, which is obviously quite cool. I hope this inspired you for server use. And again, then you, the use case, of course, is you detach with control AD for detach, log out of your server. By the way, I hope I don't leak here. I already tried to configure it, so not to leak here anything of substance, obviously. Then you exit your secure shell session and the next day or night or whatever you log into your server again and screen-r or tmux attach something and back you have your session with all your builds or fancy whatever server stuff running. Yeah, this error I'm actually, so this is only because, but maybe we don't continue building this. I already touched here this log files, my common stuff to step over builds, because yeah, LVM2 didn't build, but that is a story for the next live stream. Mostly going quite smooth, mostly just the usual stuff left and right that needs some fiddling with. If you're interested in this T2 cross building stuff, then best, we will make a second live stream going over some cross building details. And very, very theoretically, I have a complete ARM build. All the cross builds needed some stuff, and I have here already T2, at least some directory on the Raspberry Pi Zero that we need here in good old Mr. Robot or whatever that was tradition. And so also in another live stream, copying this over, testing ARM, because it's what we are here for the embedded fun and stuff. And yeah, LVM2, that is a PowerPC only issue that we also need to debug, because unlike the Debian people want to pretend everything does not really just work by itself. And if you want to see all those stuff fixed, then tune in for the next live stream, maybe in 5 minutes, as we have at least some people tuning in. And I hope to see you for that, and otherwise soon for the next.